could you be at risk for breast cancer?
Medical reporter Dina Baer has more on the gene mutation that no one seems to know about.
Genetic research may be exploding, but there's an information gap when it comes to spreading the new information. After learning she carried a lesser-known but equally life-altering genetic mutation, one patient made sure she got the word out.
I had a lumpectomy, 6 months of chemo, 6 weeks of radiation.
Susan Berger was diagnosed with breast cancer in 1997 after a routine mammogram.
I'm, knock on wood, cancer-free since then.
A few years later, the mother of three daughters underwent genetic testing to see if she carried the mutations known as BRCA 1 and 2 that increase a person's risk for the disease.
I have three daughters. I was really happy to know that the BRCA mutation, I didn't have that.
But 24 years later, the 69-year-old, who's now a health reporter, received surprising news, and not from her doctors.
So in April, I got a phone call from my oldest daughter, who had gone through some genetic testing, found out she had something called PALB2. I had no idea what that was.
This is a visual graphic of the PALB2 gene.
PALB2 is a gene that normally helps repair DNA damage in the body and fight off cancer. When there's a mutation,
it's not destiny. It doesn't guarantee someone will develop a cancer, but it allows us to know we should be doing something different from a screening and prevention standpoint.
Unlike the commonly talked about BRCA 1 and 2, a PALB2 mutation is not as widely known, even though testing for it became available more than 7 years ago, and it's associated with three different diseases.
It's hard to keep up for any busy clinician and patient. It's a fast-moving field.
Here's how PALB2 measures up. The average woman carries about a 12% lifetime risk for developing breast cancer. That risk jumps to 40 to 60% when PALB2 malfunctions. In comparison, BRCA 1 and 2 increases a person's risk 60 to 80%. When it comes to ovarian cancer, the average lifetime risk is 1 to 2%. It's 4 to 5% for those who carry the mutation. And for pancreatic cancer, instead of the typical 1.5% risk for the disease, with PALB2, there's a 5 to 10% risk over the course of a lifetime.
Being a 24-year breast cancer survivor, and I've been a health reporter for about 15 years, I read everything. I figured if I don't know, no one knows.
Susan was right. After learning she too carries the PALB2 mutation, she wrote about the lesser-known genetic risk for the New York Times. Her article generated widespread response from patients and doctors.
I had messages from doctors from Harvard and Johns Hopkins and thanking me, and genetic doctors thanking me for the awareness.
Instead of more intense screening, Susan has opted for prophylactic procedures. She had her ovaries and fallopian tubes removed and is considering a double mastectomy to protect herself from a cancer recurrence. And now her daughters are considering similar procedures.
We were all pretty upset, but when we really sat down to think about it, we realized that it's a heads up. We know what to look for.
We still have a ways to go, but we've got to tackle this awareness issue.
We feel lucky that we had the heads up, my girls and I.
So who should undergo testing for the PALB2 mutation? If you have a family history of ovarian or pancreatic cancer, or had a diagnosis of breast cancer before age 45, talk with a genetic specialist. And there's an online support group for those with PALB2. We have links for that on our website. Back to you.
Thank you, Dina.